C'est avec un grand plaisir que je participe avec vous au lancement de cet important événement qui concerne bien sûr deux grands thèmes, deux grands domaines qui impactent aujourd'hui positivement bien sûr l'humanité. Le premier, c'est l'énergie, les énergies renouvelables, et le deuxième, c'est la recherche et l'innovation. Donc deux dynamiques, grandes dynamiques qui convergent pour permettre à l'humanité maintenant d'avoir des solutions, bien sûr, qui accompagnent toute la réforme qui existe aujourd'hui à l'échelle mondiale quant au modèle de développement socio-économique dans les différents pays, et plus particulièrement dans les pays en voie de développement, et à commencer par notre pays. Mais bien sûr, ils permettent aussi de répondre aux différents défis des changements climatiques. Troisièmement, ils permettent aussi de répondre aujourd'hui aux grandes questions qui s'imposent durant cette grave pandémie et qui vont s'imposer après donc la pandémie. Donc, vous êtes... certainement les thèmes que vous allez aborder vont essayer de prendre en considération ces trois grandes dynamiques. Comme j'ai dit, la première, c'est la réforme, bien la révision ou la revue des modèles de développement socio-économique dans les différents pays, en particulier, comme j'ai dit, dans les pays en voie de développement. Deuxième, la dynamique énergétique aujourd'hui et la recherche des solutions énergétiques pour les grands pays et les petits pays, mais plus particulièrement dans les pays en voie de développement et surtout en Afrique aujourd'hui qui est en quête de solutions énergétiques pour répondre à la demande de la population, bien sûr à la demande de l'économie africaine qui commence à se développer d'une manière conséquente. Et bien sûr, troisièmement, c'est comment peut-on répondre à cette pandémie et l'après-pandémie en utilisant donc les différentes technologies des énergies propres dont on a besoin dans les domaines social, mais aussi dans le domaine économique, parce qu'on veut atteindre la compétitivité en réduisant les coûts, mais bien sûr, on veut produire propre, parce que, comme j'ai dit, les enjeux sont là, et les transformations à l'échelle mondiale, si on ajoute à ça la taxe carbone, donc il faut produire propre, et donc il faut utiliser une énergie propre dans les différents domaines de production, en particulier dans le domaine industriel. La pandémie nous a et a confirmé la nécessité de booster la recherche, la nécessité de faire confiance aux chercheurs, la nécessité bien sûr de leur permettre d'être si vous voulez, d'être proche du pouvoir de décision, parce que sans recherche on ne peut pas avoir des solutions pour les situations normales. Et bien sûr, pour les situations exceptionnelles, en particulier cette situation de pandémie qui aujourd'hui impose à ce qu'on trouve des solutions, pas uniquement dans le domaine technologique industriel, même dans le domaine social, dans tous les domaines, on a besoin aujourd'hui d'innover, on a besoin aujourd'hui de chercher de nouvelles solutions, on a besoin aujourd'hui d'adapter ce qui existe à ce contexte qui est très, très difficile. Je vous remercie pour l'insistance d'organiser donc l'événement et chez nous, même si c'est virtuellement, j'espère que l'année prochaine va être en présentiel et bien sûr, on pourra avoir des événements en hybride, avoir en présentiel, mais en même temps en virtuel. La technologie nous permet aujourd'hui de dépasser les frontières, nous permet aujourd'hui de partager les connaissances, nous permet aujourd'hui de trouver des solutions communes et j'espère que les recommandations, les résultats, les outputs de votre conférence va nous permettre tous à avoir, si vous voulez, des orientations au domaine de l'innovation et de la recherche. Sachez que dans aujourd'hui, les décideurs dans les différents pays, en particulier au Maroc et en Afrique, ils font confiance aux chercheurs et la confiance gagne du terrain davantage. comme j'ai dit, vu la nécessité aujourd'hui de trouver, comme j'ai dit, des nouveaux modèles de développement, mais aussi la pandémie maintenant, ajoutée à ça, la pandémie, cette convergence entre les décideurs et les chercheurs nous permettra d'avoir les bonnes solutions pour les problèmes qu'on vit actuellement. Entre la dernière conférence et cette conférence, ça fait à peu près un bon moment. J'avais l'occasion de présenter donc les tendances dans mon pays, mais entre-temps, nous avons lancé pas mal d'initiatives, pas mal de réflexions. Aujourd'hui, on est en train de revoir notre cadre réglementaire pour permettre plus d'investissement, pour faciliter l'investissement, pour permettre même la recherche. Donc, nous avons préparé le code gazier. Il est en cours de discussion pour qu'il soit finalisé, sachant que les énergies renouvelables et les énergies fossiles, entre parenthèses, propres, vont cohabiter ensemble d'ici pendant les trois décennies à venir. Donc, on a intérêt, bien sûr, à avoir de l'innovation quant à cette mixité entre les énergies renouvelables et les énergies fossiles. Et je crois qu'on a la possibilité d'avoir cette convergence en utilisant les solutions innovantes. Nous avons aussi préparé la loi 1309, c'est la loi qui permet au privé de produire pour le privé, c'est-à-dire c'est la loi qui concerne la marge qu'on pourra donner au privé pour produire de l'électricité pour le consommateur privé. Donc on a revu cette loi pour qu'elle soit une loi qui permet plus de compétition et plus de visibilité, et qui permet bien sûr d'avoir un équilibre entre le système d'électricité publique qui existe et le système privé qui se développe. Eh bien, on a préparé la loi sur l'autoproduction. C'est une tendance à l'échelle mondiale. Aujourd'hui, tout le monde veut produire sa propre énergie, sa propre électricité. Et donc, il faut l'encadrer par une réglementation qui permette bien sûr de permettre cette liberté énergétique, entre parenthèses, mais aussi de garder l'équilibre du système électrique qui a demandé beaucoup d'investissements et qui est érigé par des contrats à long terme. Donc, permettre l'autoproduction en même temps, préserver l'équilibre du système électrique, c'est une obligation, c'est un devoir du pouvoir public, donc d'encourager l'autoproduction, mais en même temps de préserver l'équilibre du système électrique. Et on a besoin des innovations en la matière, parce qu'on va permettre bien sûr aux citoyens, aux consommateurs d'utiliser, comme j'ai dit, des outils qui existent. Il faut que des outils soient normalisés, soient acceptés en utilisant des normes. Donc on a besoin d'innover en matière de normalisation. L'autoproduction certainement va imposer à ce qu'il y ait des excédents en matière d'électricité qu'il faut injecter dans le réseau. Donc il faut innover. Comment peut-on accepter cette injection sans, impacter négativement le système électrique, tant au niveau technique, au niveau économique et financier. Donc, c'est hausse. Et on commence à préparer, disons, un cadre réglementaire quant à l'hydrogène. Ça, c'est le premier axe concernant le cadre réglementaire. Mais bien sûr, il y a d'autres textes qui sont en cours de révision pour qu'on puisse être adapté à l'évolution technologique, à l'évolution du marché. Deuxième axe sur lequel on a travaillé depuis la dernière conférence jusqu'à aujourd'hui, on a travaillé sur la revue de pas mal de programmes. Vous vous souvenez que Sa Majesté nous avait demandé travailler sur de nouveaux programmes. Et là, on a reçu des orientations en la matière et nous sommes en train de revoir notre stratégie, parce que après l'implémentation de cette stratégie, pendant une dizaine d'années, nous avons atteint des résultats. Certainement, il y a des insuffisances, certainement, il y a des choses qui ont évolué en matière technologique, mais aussi en matière économique, mais même en matière de nouveaux systèmes de contrats entre le public et le privé. Donc, on a intérêt, et même la demande a évolué d'une manière conséquente. Donc, il faut prendre ça en considération pour préparer la nouvelle version de notre stratégie 2000, 2030. Ajouté à ça, nous avons travaillé sur la feuille de route sur le gaz, qui est presque finalisée, le GNL, la feuille de route sur l'hydrogène, qui on a tenu dernièrement le comité de pilotage, et on a quelques jours pour qu'on finalise définitivement cette feuille de route hydrogène, parce qu'on considère que le Maroc pourra être une des plateformes internationales importantes en matière de production de l'hydrogène, bien sûr pour le marché international et certainement dans les décennies à venir pour le marché national, vu la projection géostratégique, vu le potentiel énergétique renouvelable qui existe dans notre pays. On a cette vue, bien sûr, les partenariats et la confiance qui existent entre le Maroc et les grands acteurs mondiaux, pays, États et entreprises et institutions. Nous avons la possibilité de capter une partie de la dynamique hydrogène qui est lancée à l'échelle mondiale. Bien sûr, nous avons aussi préparé notre feuille de route concernant la biomasse et accompagné, disons, en parallèle avec ça, nous essayons de booster davantage la recherche, l'innovation des plateformes qui existent, des plateformes qui sont en cours de construction. D'autres plateformes sont programmées d'ici 2030. Grosso modo, on aura à peu près, je crois, 5 jusqu'à 7, 6 plateformes avec des laboratoires décentralisés dans les instituts, les universités, dans des centres de recherche. Donc, c'est un système de recherche qui devra accompagner toute cette dynamique nationale. Et on est bien sûr connecté avec les différents centres de recherche à l'échelle mondiale, que ce soit au niveau européen, au niveau américain, au niveau asiatique. Voilà quelques mots que je voulais vous dire. J'ai essayé de me concentrer sur cette période entre la dernière conférence et la conférence actuelle. Je vous souhaite plein succès. Je suis très content de voir ce travail qui est fait par nos chercheurs marocains. Chaque fois, on a des bonnes nouvelles, des Marocains, des jeunes, des seniors qui s'imposent à l'échelle mondiale et dont leurs compétences est reconnue à l'échelle mondiale par les institutions mondiales, par les centres de recherche. Et je suis très content de voir cette connexion entre les chercheurs marocains et les chercheurs africains et les chercheurs dans d'autres pays. C'est comme ça, comme j'ai dit, c'est comme ça qu'on pourra, comme j'ai dit, répondre aux trois dynamiques: la recherche d'un nouveau modèle de développement, l'évolution énergétique impose d'autres business models et d'autres solutions, et l'impact de la pandémie qui demande à ce qu'on ait les vraies réponses pour les vrais impacts de cette pandémie. Merci encore une fois pour votre travail, pour votre effort. Je remercie les organisateurs et bien sûr, je remercie aussi les sponsors, les différentes institutions, entreprises qui soutiennent cette initiative et l'organisation de cette conférence.
Thank you so much, Excellency, for your thoughtful and insightful speech that focused on and stressed also the importance and the need for research and innovation in the field of energy, renewable energy. You have also presented and shed light on several projects ongoing here in Morocco and several strategies and initiatives in the field of energy and renewable energy. So without much ado, I'll invite the next speaker in this panel. So the representative of PASEN, Masen is also one of the partners and sponsors of this event. So I invite Dr. Hisham Bouzekri, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. I would like firstly to thank the organizers for their resilience in organizing these events, despite the conditions under which we live today. So I'd like to welcome all of the participants and panelists to the 8th edition of the International Renewable and Sustainable Energy Conference, IRSEC 2020, held virtually this year. So despite the novel digital format, the conference successfully attracted more than 1,000 requests for participation from 80 countries. So this is a testament to the growing international reputation of the conference. It, in our view, further strengthens its position as a leading regional conference on renewable energy. This is an important point because Morocco is a leading country in terms of developing renewable energy and has been given an example regionally. So we think that research should be at that level also, and we're happy to see that the conference contributes to this image installed by Morocco. Another very positive aspect is the virtual expo that attracted 15 companies. And this is a proof also that industry is keeping an eye on what's happening on research. This is essential for the technology transfer, and the conference is seeking to become a bridge between academia and industry. Morocco's leading role in promoting renewable energy sources, as was highlighted by the minister, covers multiple aspects, but in particular, the significant part of renewable energy in the electricity generation capacity, I think, places Morocco above most of the other countries. So this is also thanks to Mazen's innovative approach to develop world-leading renewable energy plants, such as the Norwars Azat, which is still today the biggest operating solar multi-technology plant in the world. But this dynamic of developing large-scale utility renewable energy plant is creating attraction for the regional research ecosystem. And we hope that this will push the research and innovation further into the road of excellence, because this is what guarantees the future. So undoubtedly, IRSEC is today one of the largest renewable energy conferences in the MENA region, but also in Africa. And as the minister also highlighted, this is an honor for Morocco to have served as the cradle for this conference, and we're very happy to see it continue to become an exchange platform for innovation, research and development in renewable energy between the Moroccan diaspora, the Moroccan researcher here in Morocco, and international researcher around the world. We certainly hope that this exchange platform is creating synergies, because this is what will most benefit the young researchers, which are the future of this sector. Mazen is very happy to have continuously supported IRSEC, and this is also a proof that Mazen believes in national research, believes that research is needed for renewable energy developments here and around the world. Mazen has continuously also supported scientific research in Morocco in a number of initiatives. And we are in particular keen to support market-aligned R&D initiatives that put on the market relevant technologies. We have to remember that the challenge for all of us is to create high added value jobs for the youth coming up from universities. And we think that research, when it is correctly targeting these opportunities, creates this high value opportunities for the young coming from the universities. In particular, within the renewable energy realm, I think particularly storage is a fast-paced innovative sector, and we think that many opportunities to improve the existing technologies in terms of performance, in terms of reliability, in terms of competitiveness, are out there, and for the researchers to capture these opportunities and make products for them. We at Mazen are very happy and always welcoming real scale or real life utility scale demonstrators to be hosted in our platform in Norwars Azat. Mazen has done a lot in terms of advancing the global agenda for renewable energy development. And in particular, it has a number of firsts, especially in terms of utility scale storage technologies, from molten salts for parabolic trough plants, but also towers. And also now increasingly hybrid PV CSP plants. We think that this dynamic that is created by the approach of innovation that Mazen has brought to the table should benefit and should lead researchers to go further down that road. As Mazen is celebrating its 10th anniversary, we are satisfied to see that our unwavering support has allowed IRSEC to soar to new horizons. We wish the conference organizers, panelists, and all participants a productive and fruitful virtual conference. And the conference can always rely on Mazen to lead the way in making Morocco a shining place for research, innovation in renewable energy. And thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Bouzikri, for your welcome note. Our next speaker is Mr. Philippe Schattenmann from GIZ. The floor is yours.
Yes. Good morning, everybody. Monsieur le ministre, monsieur le président directeur général de Mazen, représenté par cher ami Bouzikri, messieurs les présidents des universités Mohamed V et de l'université polytechnique Mohamed VI, monsieur le doyen de la faculté des sciences de Tétouan, humble assistance. For me, it is also an honor to be among you this morning and to have the opportunity to give some welcome notes. Thank you, dear Minister, for your tour d'horizon, the very impressive way that Morocco is turning was again quite visible, and we from German Development Corporation, we are very happy to have such a strong and committed partner. We can team up. GIZ and German Development Corporation have this conference, the International Renewable and Sustainable Energy Conference, at heart, and that mainly for two reasons. First of all, and that was also already said by you, dear Minister, we believe that research and development is a major cornerstone of the energy transition, and also a precondition for creation of local content in the countries engaging on this journey. And secondly, we believe also that research needs to be as collaborative as possible. And a conference like this, bringing together researchers as well as industrial political players or investors, is key. So IRSEC is an event that embodies perfectly those two principles. As GIZ and German Development Corporation, we first of all, would like to thank you for your trust, for being one of your partners and supporter of this conference. In fact, the cooperation between Morocco and Germany in the field of research has intensified considerably in the last years. And following the before-mentioned National Energy Strategy, we have worked together with the partners on several aspects, and I would like to mention three of them right now. First of all, is the focus was on contributing to the development of best research infrastructure. Here, GIZ teamed up with several strong Moroccan institutions and partners and supported the setup of an excellent technological platforms. And maybe as we function by nature of a technical cooperation, GIZ is acting here mainly as a facilitator and enabler, a sparing partner, but also to some extent, we could support the partners to provide some innovative equipment for laboratories in Morocco. And if we accumulate this figure, it's nearly 1 million euros, which has been put aside for this in the last, between 2015 and 2020. Secondly, we believe also that the link to industry and the private sector is key. And that is why we encourage private investment in the scientific research in order to create innovative startups and spin-offs. And in this sense, we support several activities to valorize and promote technological transfer. And we work on strengthening and boosting these ties between the scientific research and the private sector. One example is a digital online platform called Jisri, the bridge, which soon will be launched, where GIZ has supported this. And last, we in general try to support the Moroccan partners to focus the research on a broad range of topics, whether it is energy efficiency, making digitalization work for the sake of energy transition. And for sure, it was also mentioned, which a new topic, which we see as a big opportunity and needs also a promotion of the whole ecosystem in the R&D, is the topic of Power2X. And this is will also, on this topic in the future, we will concentrate a lot of our efforts in our Moroccan-German cooperation. So the conference IRSEC and GIZ has now a long relationship, 7 years already, and we are following with a great pleasure this event, supporting it, and see this event growing more and more and becoming a key event on the topic here in the region. And I think to participate is a great chance to receive information about the latest innovations, about deepening the knowledge, get feedback from the researchers in the world, as well as here in Morocco, industrialists and economic stakeholders. This is an excellent marketplace for ideas. And the famous historian once said, to trade ideas is even more important than to trade good, or kind of a precondition to do so. So in this context, I would like to thank the team organizing this edition of the conference and the great efforts provided, especially the two co-chairs, Professor Zas and Professor Esaidi. And for sure, last but not least, all the researchers in Morocco and around the world that will give precious inputs to this conference. I'm looking forward to it. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Shutterman. Now I give the floor to Mr. Alhabti, president of University Mohammed VI Polytechnic. So the floor is yours, Mr. Alhabti.
Thank you. Thank you, Sisaidi. Bonjour, good morning, assalamu alaikum. Monsieur le ministre, dear colleagues, I'm very pleased and very honored to be with you this morning to welcome you today to the 8th edition of the International Renewable and Sustainable Energy Conference, IRSEC 20, organized in very special circumstances. We hope to be able to host you physically at Mohammed VI Polytechnic University in the coming edition next year. As a partner of this conference, UM6P is committed to play a leading role in promoting research, education, and entrepreneurship in the different fields of renewable energy. As you know, energy independence, preservation of the environment, limitation of greenhouse gas emissions, and the fight against climate change are all topics that concern each and every one of us. And we at the University of Mohammed VI Polytechnic will make all necessary efforts to support activities and events that bring Morocco and the international community forward in these areas. I'm very happy to see that the organizers have succeeded to assemble a pool of national and international experts of the highest caliber. And I'm looking forward to a couple of days of top scientific debate in the fields of renewable energies. I thank all the organizers for setting up such an outstanding list of plenary and invited speakers. In the program, we have a workshop on advances in lithium-ion battery and beyond, chaired by our colleague, Dr. Amin Khalid, who is also an adjunct professor at our university. The lithium battery workshop will be dedicated to the state of the state of lithium battery science and technology, as well as the current and future storage applications in transportation, commercial, aerospace, grid storage, stationary, and other promising sectors. It will encompass the branches of materials chemistry, materials designs, new battery chemistry, and computer science that directly impact energy storage. I encourage researchers and research students, as well as industrials participating in this edition of IRSEC, to use this platform to exchange and network and also benefit from the tutorials given in conjunction with the conference. Enjoy your conference and hope to see you all at UM6B next year.
Thank you so much, Serapti, for the insightful talk. I will now move to the next speaker in our list in this session, who is Professor Mohamed Al-Ghashi, who is the president of Mohammed V University in Rabat, Morocco. We have a recorded talk. We will play right now. So Youssef, can you just play? Okay. Thank you.
Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Prof. Mohamed Ghashi, President of Mohammed V University of Rabat. It is a pleasure to be here with you and be involved in this special and highly important event, the 8th International Renewable and Sustainable Energy Conference. Special in the sense that due to COVID-19, this edition is going to be held virtually, totally online, but this does not mean that this is going to minimize the importance of this event. No, on the contrary, we strongly believe that this international forum, like its previous ones, will be an inspiring opportunity for people, for academia, industry, researchers, policymakers, engineers, PhD and master students, and other people who are interested in all issues related to renewable and sustainable energy. Renewable energy solutions provide clean, reliable, and cost-effective energy for essential services, including healthcare, water, and food supply. After all, renewable energy can play a key role in economic recovery, ensuring sustainability and energy security, creating jobs and help build resilience to protect people's health and welfare, and making the air safer and breathe. Important in so far as it addresses key issues and key concerns about the future of our planet. Solar energy, wind energy, green technology, renewable energy for IT equipment, hydroelectric power, to name a few. Ladies and gentlemen, Morocco is making significant efforts to advance and build a sustainable energy economy. In the course of last decade, various effective policies have been developed and implemented to support growth in wind and solar power in order to reduce climate change, pollution, and sustain economic prosperity. As you may know, in Morocco, under the enlightened vision of His Majesty King Mohammed VI, has launched one of the world's largest and most ambitious solar energy plan. It is regarded as a milestone on the country's path towards a secure and sustainable energy supply, which is clean, green, and affordable. The solar power complex at Wurzazat, also known as Noor, considered as one of the world's largest solar power plants, is the first project to be implemented under the Moroccan solar plan, while others in Laayoune, Boujdour, Tarfaya, and El Mimtar shall complete Morocco's vision, projected to have achieved 52% renewable energy by 2030. Today, it's our role to discuss and identify concrete actions that will be able to prepare and reinforce the industrial competitiveness of Morocco's renewable energy industry. Ladies and gentlemen, in this international forum, through its workshops, special sessions, and tutorials, we will be listening to a very diversified range of speakers, going from entrepreneurs to researchers, investors, and development practitioners. Their presentations will give us a good picture of the present status in the sector of renewable and clean energy, of the technical and economic options at present available, and of the different factors that have to be taken into account when dealing with renewable and sustainable energy sources. With these words, ladies and gentlemen, I do wish you some interesting days ahead on this platform, and I sincerely hope that some useful results will come out of your discussions. I wish you a most successful conference. I thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Lagassi. Now we'll move to the next speaker in the list of the panelists in this session. So we have also another recording from Professor Mustafa Stitu, who is the interim president of Abd Malik Saadi University in Tetouan, Morocco.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a moment of great privilege to welcome all of you today to the 8th edition of the International Conference on Renewable and Sustainable Energy, organized and broadcast as an online event from Morocco during November the 25th to the 28th, 2020, due to the current COVID-19 pandemic. The virtual edition held under the auspices of the Moroccan Ministry of Energy, Mines and Environment is organized by the Mediterranean Space of Technology and Innovation in collaboration with the Moroccan Agency for Sustainable Energy, German Corporation, Mohammed VI Polytechnic University in Benguerir, Abdel Malek Saadi University in Tetouan, Mohammed V University in Rabat, and several other national and international organizations and partners. The scope of IRSEC 20 provides an excellent opportunity to share insights, knowledge and research findings and advances among world experts, academics, industrialists and decision makers on a wide range of subjects related to renewable energy, energy storage, and energy efficiency. The conference offers a vibrant program which includes outstanding key talks, live presentations and discussions, as well as a series of workshops, tutorials, and activities conducted by renowned speakers, experts, and academicians, and enriched by participants representing 40 different nationalities. Furthermore, the conference will host a virtual session for national and international exhibitors whose work matches up with IRSEC's areas of interest and set of objectives. As president of Abd al-Malik Saadi University, which is an essential partner of IRCEC, I would like to express my sincere thanks and heartfelt appreciation to the organizing committee for the great work it invested in making this online conference happen. I also express warm-hearted welcome to our exceptional and outstanding guest speakers, participants, and partners. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Sito. Now I will move to the next speaker. So I invite Professor Abdellatif Mukrim, who is the Dean of the Faculty of Science of Al-Malik Saad University in Tetouan. So the floor is yours.
Thank you, dear Professor Saadi. Je voudrais, de la Faculté des Sciences de Tétouan, Université Abdelmalek Saali, exprimer mes félicitations au comité d'organisation qui ont défié la pandémie et qui ont capitalisé autour de cette édition pour organiser la 8e édition de la Conférence internationale sur les énergies renouvelables et durables, ERSEC 2020, qui se tient cette année en ligne pour les raisons liées à la pandémie. Et je les félicite également pour le choix des thématiques traitées et qui ont positionné l'innovation au centre de toutes les activités de cette conférence. ERSEC est devenu un rendez-vous incontournable, non seulement d'échange et de transfert de connaissances entre les chercheurs, mais également entre les chercheurs et les professionnels, les industriels. Donc, sur cet aspect-là, et avec la participation de nos chercheurs à l'échelle régionale, à l'échelle nationale et internationale, nous contribuons dans cette stratégie et cette vision de notre pays qui place les énergies renouvelables à un niveau prioritaire et qui font de ce chantier non seulement un chantier capital pour le développement socio-économique, mais également pour des raisons environnementales qui touchent notre pays et qui touchent le globe entier. Donc, je félicite le comité d'organisation et je cite particulièrement mes collègues, le professeur Saïdi, le professeur Zaz et le professeur El-Hibaoui. Je remercie nos partenaires et nos sponsors, donc nos partenaires, l'Espace méditerranéen de technologie et d'innovation, le ministère, et nous sommes honorés aujourd'hui par la présence de monsieur le ministre d'énergie, de mines et d'environnement avec nous, Mazen, l'université Mohamed VI Polytechnique, l'université Mohamed V de Rabat, notre université, l'université Abdelmalek Saadi et l'Agence allemande de coopération internationale pour le développement GIZ. Donc, il s'agit d'un programme riche où il y a des ateliers, où il y a des tutoriels, des conférences. Nous souhaitons beaucoup de succès à cette édition comme les autres éditions et je renouvelle mes remerciements à mes collègues qui étaient derrière l'organisation de cet événement malgré la pandémie et ses contraintes.
Merci, Professeur McLean. Now I'll move to the next speaker in the list. Actually, it's me, so I'll deliver a quick welcome speech. Excellency, the Minister of Energy, Mines and Environment, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. May I first of all express a warmest welcome to you all to the 8th edition of the International Renewable and Sustainable Energy Conference, organized as a virtual event as a consequence of the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. This pandemic has also caused more disruption to the energy sector than any other event in recent history, leaving impact that will be felt for years to come. According to recently published International Energy Agency, World Energy Outlook report, which examines in detail the effects of the pandemic and in particular how it affects the prospects for rapid clean energy transitions. According to this report, global energy demand is set to drop by 5% in 2020, energy-related CO2 emissions by 18% and energy investment by 18%. The impact vary by fuel also. The estimated falls of 8% in oil demand and 7% in coal use stand in sharp contrast to slight rise on the contribution of renewables. The reduction in natural gas demand is around 3%, while global electricity demand looks set to be down by relatively modest 2% for the year. This is just to show you the impact of the pandemic even on the energy sector. So furthermore, renewable electricity additions over the next 5 years or so will top 700 gigawatts, which will account for almost 2/3 of net additions to global power capacity. Non-hydro sources such as wind and solar photovoltaic energy will represent nearly half of the total global power capacity increase. The cost of most of the renewable energy has been decreasing dramatically during the last years. The fact that is enabling its widespread deployment worldwide, even in developing countries. In this regard, as it was mentioned by several speakers in this panel, Morocco is carrying out a very ambitious expansion plan, at leveraging wind, solar, and hydroelectric power generation capacity and associated infrastructure that should see the country get something like 52% of its electricity from renewable in short term. Ladies and gentlemen, may I address the Minister of Energy, Mines and Environment for my most sincere thanks for his continued and invaluable support and sponsorship to ERSIC, which represent an outstanding contribution in the success it has. I would like also to thank Mason, GIZ, and for the partnership, support, and sponsorship they have been providing to ERSIC since its very first editions. The overwhelming success of ERSIC 20 organized in a very exceptional circumstances this year, which attracted contributions from the 5 continents and especially many keynote talks, tutorials, and invited talks on key issues, technologies, and applications of renewable energy and energy, is doubtlessly the result of the passion, commitment, perseverance, implication, and hard work of its different stakeholders, particularly the steering, organizing, and technical program committee members, keynote and invited speakers, technical sponsors, and all the participants. I seize this opportunity to address all of them, and in particular to the general co-chair, Dr. Zaz, Professor Zaz, and to all the members of the organizing committee, my most sincere thanks and gratitude for the wonderful job they have been doing during several months. I also wish the participants and guests a very fruitful ERSIC 20 and a very pleasant, enjoyable, and rewarding experience. So now I'll move the floor to the general co-chair, Professor Zaz, for also his comment on this edition.
Thank you, Professor Mohamed Saidi.
Distinguished guests, keynotes, and invited speakers, technical program committee members, colleagues, and participants. It gives me great pleasure to extend to you all a very warm welcome on behalf of the organizing committee of the 8th edition of the International Renewable and Sustainable Energy Conference, ERSIC 20. Placed under the auspices of the Ministry of Energy, Mines and Environment, the ERSIC 20 is organized by the Mediterranean Space of Technology and Innovation, MSTI, in a strategic partnership with the Moroccan Agency for Sustainable Energy, MASEN. ERSIC is also supported by German Agency for International Cooperation, GIZ, Mohammed V University in Rabat, Abd Malik Saadi University in Tetouan, Mohammed VI Polytechnic University, and many other organizations. ERSIC is distinguished by Google Scholar Global Ranking. ERSIC publications are now the only African and MENA ranked in the top 20 publications in the field of solar energy. 14 in the world, with first 5 index of 14. Due to COVID-19 pandemic, this edition is organized virtually and broadcasted from Tetouan, Morocco. The participation is totally free of charge. No paper submission was requested. Outstanding keynote talk scheduled in workshop and special session will tackle cutting-edge technology and hot topics related to renewable energy, energy storage, and energy efficiency. Moreover, industrials and researchers, both PhD holders and PhD students were encouraged to submit 5-minute video presentation of their latest or ongoing research in the, to be presented in this edition. Selected presenters will be invited to prepare a full paper to be considered in partner journals.
This is some photo from previous edition. Statistics, evolution of IRSEC from the first edition to the previous edition. IRSEC is a series of 6 workshops, 4 specializations, and 3 tutorials. The first workshop, Advances in Lithium-Ion Battery and Beyond, chaired by Dr. Amir Khalil, and there are 6 high-level keynote speakers with a very high IH index. The second workshop is Emerging Semiconductors for Photovoltaic Application, chaired by Professor Shahzada Ahmed and Professor Mohammed Hajan Nazaruddin. As we see, Professor Nazaruddin has an H index of 162. They're a very, very high level scientist. Third workshop, the workshop of CSP and thermal storage development perspective, chaired by Dr. Hisham Guskri from Mazel. Fourth workshop, energy efficiency in buildings and construction sector, chaired by colleagues from EST and the ENAT MAT 21, and moderated by Dr. Enrico Francio Fabrizio and Professor Mohamed Melkevi. The next presentation just after this opening will be Professor Matthews Santamoris from University of New South Wales in Sydney, Australia. The workshop 5, Power to X, chaired by our colleagues Mustafa Jawid from France and Professor Tariq Shafiq from Tangier, Morocco, with presence of high-level scientist Professor Mohamed Doudi with an NASH index of 90 and Professor Thomas von Appel from Germany. Workshop 6, Digital Technologies in Solar Energy, chaired by Dr. Saad Mutahar and moderated by Professor Ali Ahitouf, with presence of high-level scientists such as Professor Josep Guerrero with a NASH index of 106. The first specialization is magnetocaloric refrigeration, scheduled on Sunday. The second session, biomass and biogas energy in circular economy context. The third specialization, wind energy, electric production and grid integration. The fourth session, photovoltaic in Morocco. This was yesterday to promote and to discuss about photovoltaic in Morocco. It was animated by Professor Amir Khalil Bid and Mr. Mohamed Ouhmid and Professor Ali Haji. The first tutorial was done by Dr. Mouad Dehbi and Dr. Fouad Gamous from France. Dr. Mouad Dehbi helped us all during this conference in doing this tutorial and other things in this conference. Professor Al-Mahdi Salmani animated tutorial too. And Dr. Derda Kastani from WeLearn Casablanca animated tutorial on building information modeling. Thanks for GIZ for supporting this tutorial. I want to thank all TPC members of this conference, even if there is no paper review in this edition, continue supporting us as previous editions. Thanks also for all organizing committee members. There are also virtual exhibition in this edition. Many companies from Morocco and abroad, from Brazil, UK, are also presented in this, are present in this virtual exhibition. This is the list of companies. Thank you very much.